balanced on my school books right now. And at an angle, that's gonna bother me. Hey guys, well, so you see me in sweatpants and a hoodie. Normally I don't film videos like this, but my class was canceled and Maryland weather is weird and it's 60 degrees in September and there is a cricket in my kitchen. So it's like hiding so I can't find it and I can't spray Raid because it's where food is made. So I'm not exactly feeling the greatest and I wanted to talk to you guys about something that I thought about yesterday because I had a lot of time to think about it. Have you ever been in a situation where you have dated people? Let's say, let's use my example, 10 to be exact. You've dated that many people or you've messed around with that many people. I don't know how your life is. I don't know how you live your life. I mean, no judgment here. And you think that you're never going to find love because if that failed that many times, then no matter how anybody tells you that's normal, that's normal. You feel like you're not normal. I've been feeling that because I understand that it's normal. You have to go through certain people to get to the one that you're gonna be with. But after an amount of time and a certain number, you start to feel like you've gone through all your options and there's no other person. You also have the problem of you had such a promising person that you thought it could work out with and it didn't work out with them. So then you decided to give up. I said, why is it blurry? I'm right here. I said that I was going to take a year off of dating to see where I am. I know you can't exactly put a time limit on those things, but I'm just here to say maybe people should. Because maybe if you put a time limit to get your goals done, it'll make you go even farther to get your goals. Or maybe some people need a year break on relationships, or people need a year break on maybe people will take this year is the year for them to start exercising or go on a healthy diet with exercise, you know, that healthy workout diet type of thing. Those things are things that you can take a year to work on. So maybe you need a year to work on your well-being and your mental health before you can jump into a relationship. And that's what I'm trying to do, and that's totally normal. The way that I explain it, it doesn't come out the right way because that's not how people think I'm saying it. And so it gets really, really frustrating when I try to say what I'm saying and people just shut me down and say it's wrong, and I'm like, no, that's not what I meant. What I meant is that it's hard to explain, but maybe I just need a year off from dating and relationships in general. So there's that. But also, not just with the promising and it ended, you have to go through a lot of people. Every relationship in my life, like that other people, like my parents and other people in my family have had, everything worked out perfectly for them. They found each other, they got married. Their parents put them together to meet. They found each other, they got married, happily ever after. Everybody in my family, even my cousins, seem to get these happily ever after relationships. And I'm stuck here like, well, why can't I have that? Why can't I get that? And it seems like such a long time that I'm waiting. One for them, it happens so quickly. And yeah, okay, I'm young. I just turned 20. I still have time. But the older you get, you realize the less time you have for these things. And I'm living my life, not worried about relationships, going through school, doing what I have to do. But at the end of the day, you're left alone with your thoughts. And if your thoughts are constantly that you're gonna die alone or whatever, that's what I'm left with. And it sucks because I can't get those bad thoughts out of my head. As much as I try, they're here to stay. They're not gonna go away. And another thing. I seem to attract the douchebag population. A lot of my, I need to sneeze, hold on. My my allergies. A lot of my relationships in the past have been with douchebags. And I don't mean, like, I mean douchebags. You guys know, they're on my YouTube channel. One of the biggest isn't, but whatever. So yeah, I mean, it just sucks that people feel like they have to, I hate when people feel like they're entitled to an answer from you. Like, you'll say something and then, like, you'll put up something. Like, I put up that I was listening to Black Veil Brides a couple of days ago. Or, like, maybe a week ago. It was up, I put it up at some point. And all of the messages were from people asking me if I was okay. Just because I'm listening to Black Veil Brides doesn't mean I want to kill myself. Just because I'm listening to Lewis Capaldi doesn't mean I want to kill myself. Maybe I just like their music. Frankly, the fact that they have depressing music isn't my fault. And it's like, everybody likes a different type of music. This is going up on Wednesday because I need to know that I'm not alone. And there's a quote that my friend told me. The only day you have at the end of the day is yourself. I understand that. I get it. And you know that there's another thing where it's like you need to learn to love yourself before you can be with somebody else. They say that's bullshit. Yet one of those people that was talking to me told me that that is what you need to do. Because here's the truth of that. If you don't love yourself, you won't care what happens to you. And that was me senior year. So if you don't love yourself at all, you won't care what happens to you, and that's a really dangerous situation to put yourself in. And I think people need to realize that, because if you don't love yourself or care about yourself, you could put yourself into some pretty scary situations and it won't end well. Like, things I'm going to start talking about on this channel, the stories I have from people, or the things I found doing my research, things have gotten increasingly worse for people with one specific person. I mean, when I make those exposed videos, I'm going in on the most dangerous predators. And, you know, it's just, it's disgusting. Whether there's Nathan Darmody, who was asking girls for photos, cheating on his girlfriend, who he's still with, by the way, or if it's Dobby Vanity, we all know what that cheesehead has done. Or if it's Onision, or if it's Ashley Purdy, whoever it is that's doing this stuff, I mean, they have to be exposed, and that's why my videos are coming out on them after I do all the research to find everything that I need to. Because I have a series coming out on all of them, and it's like, I hope by making those videos I can get people that aren't afraid to come forward about anybody. Like, my exposed series is open to anybody. If you guys know anybody I should look into, comment down below. Like, I am so ready to go in on all these people. But I thought I should put this rant up here to see if I'm not alone, because some days I've been feeling like I'm alone. But anyway, see you guys in the next video. Bye.